Good evening, my dear friends. This is Dr. Das, welcoming you to attend this Akshi.com English language online program. So today we have identified the topic for discussion is sentence completion. So this is also another normal exercise testing your knowledge on preposition, verb, the use of modal auxiliaries, etc., etc. As usual, this exercise is divided into four options. So that is, there is one statement with a blank followed by four options: option A, option B, option C and option D. Sometimes this exercise has four options from prepositions, some options from adverb usage, some options are from auxiliary verbs or modal verbs. Sometimes some options are taken from sentence pattern, etc., etc. So this exercise is the product of mixed variety. You need not expect that all the examples are selected from single exercise. This is a mixed exercise where you have to look at a sentence with only one blank followed by four options. From any one of the options that suits to the blank, you can select accordingly. So in order to do this exercise, you have to recall certain areas of grammar, maybe areas of preposition, areas of modal verbs, areas of the usage of adjectives or adverbs, etc. So shall we go to the exercise now? So now this is the stem. The passengers were very happy dash the friendly and warm treatment given to them. The passengers were very happy dash the friendly and warm treatment given to them. So here there are four options: option A from, option B to, option C with, option C about. So first you read this statement four or five times and then you try to understand the meaning. So narrowing your eyes to these optional verbs and keeping your understanding on this statement, you have to select any one of these options. Any one of the options means you cannot select it irresponsible way. You have to know the meaning of each preposition, whether this meaning has a kind of suitability to the blank or not. So therefore, until you understand the meaning of the sentence, you must reread the sentence. The passengers were very happy. The passengers were very happy. Dash the friendly and warm treatment. The friendly and warm treatment given to them. So, what is the right preposition to be used in the blank? Whether are you going to use from or with or to or about? Friendly. Friendly treatment, warm treatment. So what is your option? A or C or with? The passengers were very happy with the friendly treatment. The passengers were very happy with the warm treatment. The passengers were very happy with the friendly treatment or warm treatment. So to is not suitable, about is not suitable. The passengers were very happy from the friendly and warm treatment is not suitable. So happy with the treatment, happy with the gift, happy with the respect they showed. So the passengers were happy with the warm treatment. The passengers were very happy with the friendly treatment, happy with the friendly approach, etc. So the answer is with. The passengers were very happy with the friendly and warm treatment. So here is a pause. The passengers were very happy with the friendly and warm treatment given to them. So happy the word happy should go with, should move with, should go with. So the word with can be appropriately used with the word happy. Second one, the higher you go, the more difficult it dash to breathe. The higher you go, the more difficult, the higher you go. It's a sentence pattern. This is one typical sentence pattern. The higher you go, the more difficult. The higher you go, the more difficult it dash to breathe. You cannot breathe continuously when you go higher. When you are in higher altitude, when you are flying in a higher altitude, or when you are jumping from the flight with the parachute, you feel a kind of difficulty to breathe in because of the atmosphere, because of the height. So the higher you go, the more difficult it breathes. It breathes. So the answer is becomes. The higher you go, the more difficult it becomes to breathe. So the higher you go, the higher you go. Present usage. Therefore, this is suitable. It becomes to difficult. The more difficult it becomes to breathe. The higher you go, the more difficult it becomes to breathe. Is becoming is not necessary. Has become also not necessary. Became, this is past tense. So when in the first part of the sentence is begin with the present tense, then another part in the same sentence should not be used with the past tense. Therefore, D is the correct answer. The higher you fly or the higher you go, the more difficult it becomes to breathe. The children were disappointed because they had hope dash with us. They had hope, past perfect tense. The children were disappointed because they had hoped dash with us. Hoped. Would have gone, to had gone, to have gone, to go. So what is your option, think? would have gone is not suitable because here, you know, beginning of the sentence structured with the auxiliary verb. So this is the example for perfect conditional. This is not conditional type of sentence. Therefore, you should not use the option A. So likewise, you compare. Then to go, because they had hoped to go with us. To had gone. So the structure is not possible. Maybe this is the right structure. When we compare the structure of B with the structure of C, this is not acceptable, because after two, you know, test writer had used that, this is wrong. But to have gone is possible. So you can write a sentence with to have gone. But this B structure is not very good, and nobody can use this structure. Therefore, this is eliminated because the sentence pattern is not the product of conditional, therefore this is eliminated. So to go is the correct answer. To go is the correct option for this sentence. The children were disappointed because they had hoped to go with us. She stood dash amid, but could not utter a single word. She stood dash amid, name of the person. She stood dash amid, but could not utter a single word. Utter means speak. Utter a word. She stood dash amid, but could not utter a single word. About, before, for, to. What's your option? Yes. She stood before amid, but could not utter a single word. She stood before. Before is the right option. He is the friend dash I trust most. Is the friend I trust most. Is the friend I trust most. Options are which, who, him, whom. Is the friend him I trust most. We can eliminate this by doing how I do on this slide. You can do this. Is the friend him I trust most. When you read this sentence, substituting him to the blank, it becomes very awkward. Therefore, so when you feel awkward while substituting your word, you can eliminate from this competition. And therefore, he is the friend which I trust most. So you cannot use which for animate things, friendly things, that is living things. He is the friend, human being. He is the friend, human being. For human being, you cannot use which. You cannot use which. Therefore, he is the friend dash I trust most him. So get eliminated. Then he is the friend. You have to select whether this or this. Which one you select? The right answer is whom. He is the friend whom I trust most. He is the friend whom I trust most. You must dispense dash his service. You must dispense his service. You must dispense dash his service. So, in order to find out answer for this blank, you must know or you must have the knowledge of preposition. Unless you have very strong knowledge on preposition, you cannot find out the answer, I am sure. However you are read, however you are good in grammar, when you are weak in the usage of preposition, you cannot get through in your life. Or you cannot get very good mark in the competition, a competitive examination, because preposition is a very tough area. So one cannot score 10 out of 10 or 50 out of 50 or 100 out of 100. Okay, so if you want to find out a very good answer for this blank, you must recall. So mostly you may not. So because all the students who always live with Renan Martin or any other grammar book, and the students who have very strong knowledge and preposition will immediately react to this. I am noting your answer. So no one has written correct answer. A is the correct answer, I think, because dispense is the word that ends with only with, dispense with is the appropriate preposition, appropriate usage of dispense. So why do I say British people use the preposition with along with the word of dispense? Along with the word of dispense. Okay. You cannot change certain preposition. Certain prepositions are fixed to certain verbs. You cannot change certain adjectives. Understand? Agree to, agree with, thankful to, obligated to, congratulate, when you use the word congratulate, you must use the word on, not for. Similarly, prevent is a verb form. When you use the word prevent as a verb form, you must use from is the preposition. You must use preposition from, prevent from. Similarly, suffer or suffering from. So certain prepositions are fixed to a fixed verb. There are certain prepositions which are fixed to the use of verb. Similarly, with is the preposition that should be used along with the word dispense. Whenever you use the word dispense, you should use automatically the preposition with it. Dispense with. Dispense with. Okay, so this is the. So therefore, you must read during your leisure time. You must take in or take up the Ren and Martin dictionary. Keep open the page of preposition. So there is a certain column like read out the following words and related prepositions. Following words are used with of. The following words are used with. The following words are used with into. The following words are used to on. Used with on. So there are some exercises from Ren and Martin which will tell you the right use of preposition with the verb, with the adjective, with the adverb. Now, the telephone dash several times before I answer. The telephone dash several times before I answer. So, four options, as run, was ringing, would and had run. So, first of all, you must know the grammatical rules. And then another thing, you must know what should apply. Why do we or why should we apply this? So what is the rationality behind this? You must know. The telephone dashed several times before I answered. The telephone. So note down this word here, answer, that is simple past tense, simple past. So in a sentence, simple past was used, therefore another of should be in the past perfect tense. There is a rule. What is the rule? In a single sentence, the same tense form should not be used. Or in the same sentence, two simple past tense should not be used. One form should be simple past, then another form should be past perfect tense. So keeping this rule in your mind, you must select what is your option, what is your answer listening to my rule. Had run, past perfect tense. This is not suitable. The telephone had rung several times before I answered. Because answer simple past tense. So then another fill up should be had rung because this is simple past tense. So since this sentence is the product of two sentences. What is that? The telephone had rung several times. This is one sentence. And before I arrived, another sentence. So one was in past tense, then another should be in naturally in past perfect. So you may get diverted by looking at the B. Telephone was ringing several times before I answered. Not suitable according to the grammatical rules. According to the grammatical rules, D, option D is the correct option. Option D is the correct. I shall not desert him dash all the world. I shall not desert him. So here the verb is desert. Desert him. I shall not desert him dash all the world. Which one will you use? From or for or by or with? Option D is the correct answer. Desert for all the world. Desert him for all the world. I shall not desert. Desert means here leave out. Leave. I shall not desert him for the world. Desert. So here desert is used as a verb form. Desert is used as a verb form. I bought a new car last year, but I dash my old car yet. So at present I have two cars. I bought a new car last year, but I dash my old car yet. So at present, I have two cars. I have two cars. So what is the clue? What is the clue word? So do you look at any clue word from this? It is the clue word. So when you find out a clue word from the sentence like it, what is your option or what is your idea in your mind? What are you going to select? So naturally, when a word like it is used in a sentence, it must be present perfect pattern of the sentence. It must be, the pattern must be present perfect. I bought a new car last year, but I dash my old car yet. So at present I have two cars. I dash my old car yet. So what is your option? I have sold or did not sell, could not sell, or I have not sold. What is your answer? D must be the answer. I have not sold my car yet. Blue word. I have not sold my car yet. Yet means still. I have not sold my old car yet. At present I have. So past incident, I bought a new car last year, not recently, last year, but still he has two cars, with the meaning that he has not sold out the car. So that is the meaning. I have not sold my old car. So yet is the clue word. Yet is the clue word that decides or that helps you to decide the use of the option D. I have not sold my old. No sooner did he go in, dash he came out. No sooner is the clue word. And naturally, everyone will understand when a sentence is begin with the no sooner, then automatically it goes without saying the use of than in the sentence. No sooner did he go in than he came out. So this is the clue word. No sooner is also a clue word. See, no sooner than. No sooner followed by than is the sentence pattern. Fixed sentence pattern. Even you do not know the grammatical rule behind this. Even if you don't know the grammatical rule behind this sentence, once you remember the rule, like when any sentence is begin with the no sooner, elsewhere in the middle of the sentence, there is one word like than should be used. Than should be used when a sentence is beginning with the no sooner. This is not grammar. It's a logical technique. So one can understand logically, one can understand the structure of the sentence. When a sentence beginning with no sooner than that, the judge acquitted the prisoner dash the charge of murder. The judge acquitted the prisoner. Acquitted means released. Release the prisoner. Acquitted. So acquitted is the verb form. Acquitted is the verb form. Then you have to realize, you have to tell us, out of four options, which preposition would you like to use after the verb acquit or acquitted? Whether see or from or about or with. So the students who are good at the use of preposition are the students who are good at understanding the meaning of the word acquitted, and when they read the text clearly and cleverly, they might have watched the use of only one preposition after that. it is called off, or any other word you can check, acquitted of. Acquit, acquitted. Then another word that comes after acquit should be off. No other word. No other word. So when you refer to it in any standard dictionary, a standard dictionary will show you after the word acquit, the right use of preposition is marked within the bracket. Within the bracket. So if any preposition or particle or any adverb given within the bracket, you must understand that this preposition should be used along with the main word given here. For example, the word acquit, acquit. Okay, so in the dictionary, so this is the head word. After the head word, pronunciation is shown here, pronunciation, and then functional label, and then the use of preposition. What is the meaning of this? Preposition given within the bracket means, if you want to use this word acquit, you should always use the word acquit only with this type of preposition. You should not use any other things. So once you saw the preposition or adverb given within parentheses or within bracket, you must understand this preposition should be used with this main word or verb like that. So you will get or you will gain knowledge in the case of having a standard dictionary in your house. So, acquitted of is the right answer. Acquitted. The judge acquitted the prisoner of the charge of murder. So, here also, charge of. We say charge of. Charge of murder. But not charge with murder. No. Charge to murder. Are we using any other preposition? No. We are using only of with the word charge. Charge of, acquitted of. Understand? Then, an argument dash between the two friends. The argument dash between the two friends. Argument. Broken, broke out, rose up, sprang up. The answer is broke out. The argument broke out between the two friends. Broke out. Broke out means came out, started. Argument broke out. Phrasal verb. Break out is present tense. Broke out, broken out. Phrasal verbs also have three forms. Break in, broken, broken in. Broken in. Break out, broke out, broken out. So, phrasal verbs are also used in three patterns of tenses. When I was a child, I dashed to school every day instead of going by cycle. Instead of going by cycle. So when I was a child, I dashed to school every day. Every day gives you a clue that this is a routine work. Routine work. Regular work. Every day means routine work or regular work. So regular work should be stated by using, when I was a child, I dashed to school every day instead of going by cycle. I think simple past tense is enough. I walked, because these regular things, regular happenings. Suppose if you select, when I was a child, I have walked to school every day instead of going bicycle. So, if your answer is B, then it is wrong. Why is it wrong? Because you have used the present perfect tense, which is not necessary because the sentence began with the past tense. The sentence began with the past tense. Therefore, it is incorrect to use present perfect tense that. Understand? Similarly, if you choose A, this is a past perfect tense. I was a child when I had walked to school every day instead of going. This is past perfect tense is not necessary, where simple past is enough. Regular happenings, every day also had given us a clue that we should use only simple past tense, because this is everyday activity. Going to school is an everyday activity, therefore simple past tense is enough for this exercise. Don't go for any other things. Nobody has come to see us. Nobody has come to see us dash. We bought these pious dogs. We bought these fierce dogs. Fierce dogs means, ferocious, wild, ferocious. Okay? Nobody has come to see us dash. We bought these fierce dogs. What do you mean by severe, serious? Like that. Nobody has come to see us dash. We bought these fierce dogs. So what's your answer? Can we use since? Since we bought these fierce dogs, nobody has come to see us. Okay, nobody has come to see us. Where do we use since here? So has come is present perfect tense. Present perfect tense is used. When present perfect tense is already used in the structure of the sentence, there is no harm in selection of since. Okay. And then he ran quickly or so quick or quick or so. What is your answer? He ran quickly. He ran so quickly. If you choose so quickly, you must continue the sentence. So please, selecting the answer is not important. You must learn why is B not correct. He ran quickly is correct. Okay. So okay, your problem is over. However, your problem is over, you must understand. He ran quick incorrect. He ran so quickly is also correct. And then you must write another extra extension of meaning. You must write extra sentences. He ran so quickly that you could catch the thief, like that. Once you use the word so, then you must extend your viewpoint, which is not necessary in this case. Therefore, he ran quickly, sentence is abruptly ended. If you add so, then you must extend the sentence. Therefore, this is very, very important. Then, dash the room. The door suddenly swung shut and hit him in the face. The room dash, the door suddenly swung shut and hit him in the face. So, my dear friends, my dear young learners, when you have a sentence like this, in a strange, a kind of atmosphere where sentences are used, then you have to read this 3 times, 4 times till you understand the meaning. Dash the room, the door suddenly swung shut and hit him in the face. So, you have to read. As he entered, or on having entered, or entering, or while entering, you have to fit in each option into that. And for example, if I substitute, as he entered the room, the door suddenly swung shut and hit him in the face. So what is your option? Are you going to use B or D or C? Or finally, are you decided to use A? What is your answer? So as he entered the room, the door suddenly swung shut and hit him in the face. Hit him in the face. That is very, very important. Now, once you substituted this phrase in the entry word, then it would give you complete sense. As he entered the room, the door suddenly swung shut and hit him in the face. On having entered the room, the door suddenly, so when you use this word, on having entered the room, the door suddenly swung shut and hit him. On having entered the room, when you use this expression, there is no subject. There is no subject. So the meaning would get confused. There is no subject. Please note down this. Here is the subject. Who entered? He entered. But here, who entered? There is no question. There is no answer from this question. On having entered the room, the door suddenly swung shut and hit him. Who was the person being talking about here? So in the option C, there is no subject. So in the D also same is the case. Therefore, as he entered is the correct option. As he entered the room, the door suddenly swung shut and hit him in the face. So likewise, you have to analyze your answer, whether the answer you selected is logically suitable to it or not. And mechanically, don't select answer. Or even after selection of your answer, you think whether the answer selected by you is correct or not. So this will help you to develop a kind of confidence. Okay. The doctor advised him to go several medical tests. The doctor advised him to go several medical tests. So the options are through, into, under, about. The doctor advised him to go several medical tests. Go through is the phrase, go through. Go into also phrase. Go under, no, there is no such phrase. Go under, you can go about also accepted. There are three accepted usages, excepting one under. So we eliminate the word under from this context. Now the context is whether you are going to use through or whether you are going to use into or about. So that is option is left. So I think A is the correct option. Anyhow, we can check. Go through. The doctor advised him to go through means undergo. Go through means undergo. Go through is a phrasal verb. Go through is a phrasal verb. So the doctor advised him to go through several medical tests. That is, doctor advised him. Doctor tells him to undergo. Undergo is equal to go through. Undergo is equal to go through. But here, go under is the verb. This is wrong. Don't get confused. Go through is the correct answer. Undergo is not. If you persist in telling lies to me, I shall shoot the. This is typographical error, not shoot, sue. Sue means to go to the court against you, to file a case against you in the court. This is not sure. It's a printing mistake. You can correct it. S-U-E. Sue. Sue means to file a case in the court. To file a case in the court. To file a case in the court. If you persist in telling lies to me, I shall sue you slander. Sue you. Which one are you going to use? For slander? On slander? With slander? To slander? Which one is? I think option A is the answer. For slander. For slander. For slander means corruption or any other things you can say. Blasphemy. Corruption, defame, like that. If you persist in telling lies to me, I shall sue you for slander. For is the right preposition. The waiter hasn't bought the coffee. The waiter hasn't bought the coffee. I've been here an hour already. The waiter hasn't bought the coffee. I have been here an hour already. I have been here as not present perfect tense. And then what is your option? You have to use, maybe up may not be suitable word. The waiter has not bought the coffee. The waiter has not brought. The waiter has not brought the coffee. Dash, I have been here an half an hour already. So up may not be suitable. A and D can eliminate from this competition. And then there is a tough competition between still and till. Tell me what is your option. Type it quickly. So yes, you know, yet means however, another meaning is there. However, it has another meaning however, because the concept is the waiter has not brought the coffee. Yes, yet I have been here and I have, okay, this is right. Yet up is not possible. Till I have been here, no. Yes, yet is the correct answer. Yet means however. Once you look at the word yet, you must understand the meaning however. However, I have been here an half an hour earlier or half an hour already. The modern club is simply a more refined substitute dash the old fashioned tavern. The modern club is simply a more refined substitute the old fashioned tavern. So once you use the word substitute, then you should use the appropriate, the use of preposition for. Appropriate preposition for. How can you check this? How can you check? Substitute. Substitute. Yes. Substitute for. So for is the preposition that can be used along with the word substitute, which is in verb form. So there is a proverb also. There is no substitute for hard work. There is no substitute for hard work. So hard work is essential. Hard work is important. For every successful businessman, you know, there is hard work behind their success. So substitute can take preposition, no other preposition. Okay, substitute for the old fashioned tavern. After the advice of his father, he was reconciled. He was reconciled dash his wife. Reconciled. After the advice of his father, he was reconciled. So again, reconciled, verb. So which preposition are you going to use? Are you going to use to? Are you going to use with? Which one is correct? Reconcile to his wife. But let us say what the dictionary says. So this is not the answer. Reconcile with is the answer. Reconcile with. This is wrong. No one can use the preposition to with reconcile. With is the correct option. Reconcile with. So British people will always use the preposition with the word of reconciled verb. Therefore, correct this. Don't use to with this. Therefore, with is the correct form. With is the correct form of the verb reconciled. Then, the doctor tried both penicillin and sulfanilamide. The penicillin provided to be the dash effective drug. The doctor tried both. The doctor tried both. What's that? So the first one is penicillin and the other, second one is sulfanilamide. This is one drug, this is another drug. There are two drugs are used. So here, out of these two drugs, the penicillin proved to be the effective drug. The penicillin proved to be the effective drug. So there are two drugs are taken for comparison. There are two drugs taken for comparison. Okay, therefore the right usage should be not most.
So think about the use of more. Think about the use of more. I don't know whether this is correct or not. Anyhow, you check it. But as a responsible person, I should explain why do we use more. The more, very typical structure. This is not an ordinary structure, very typical, that can be used only when we take only for two subjects for comparison. What are the two subjects? So drug penicillin and sulfonylamide. There are two drugs. Of these two drugs, penicillin proved to be so effective. For comparison, whether this is superlative form or any other form, when the word they used, automatically we should use most. But considering the number of things being compared, there are two things compared. Therefore, the more is the acceptable form, the more effective drug. The more effective drug. Some of the students may get confused looking at the word. Your teacher might have told you that you know the is the superlative form. So when you look at the word before the blank, you should select most. Most of the teachers may say, but you must understand the meaning of the sentence. Meaning of the sentence. What is the meaning here? Only two things are compared. And which one is found effective? And penicillin found to be more effective. Therefore, the more structure is advisable. The more structure is advisable, remember. However honest he dash, I do not trust him. However honest he might be, however honest he could be, however honest he is, however honest he may be. So this is very simple. However honest he is, I do not trust him. I do not trust him. But the answer is typical mistake, maybe. However honest he may be, this is not suitable. Seems to be very awkward. This is not suitable to this, but you may select this. However honest he is, this is suitable. However honest he may be, this is very not irrational thing, irrational usage of me. But in a spoken form, however honest he is, I do not trust him. So C is the right option. So eliminate this, remove this. He became the governor of a province. He became the governor of a province. Province means maybe a district or maybe three or four districts combined together. It's a larger than a district. It's a large area than a district. Larger area than a district. Province. This was the word we had been using before independence. Hyderabad province, Travancore province, like that. So he became the governor of a province. He became the governor of a province. Can you use by and large? Can you use at times? Can you use income of time? I think this is unsuitable. In no way this is suitable because he became the governor of a province, income of time. This is a meaningless option. So this meaningless option should be removed. This is not correct. This is not correct. The right answer is C is the correct. He became the governor of a province little by little, step by step of him in his career, in his political career. He became the governor of a province little by little. Sir, what do you mean by little? Means step after step. So he might be an MLA and then member of parliament and then council members, and he was close associate with the prime minister or any other leader, and then he was appointed as governor of a particular place. So little by little means step by step. Little by little means step by step. So the right answer should be C, not E. This is nonsense. He became the governor of a province a little by little. A little by little means step by step. The rain stopped. The play had to be suspended. The rain stopped. The play had to be suspended. Are you going to use since or until or when or while the play had to be suspended. So cause and effect, stop and suspension of the play. So what is your answer? Until the rain stopped. Until the rain stopped, the play had to be suspended. So when the rain is over, the play had to continue. So until there is a condition, until the rain stopped, the play had to be suspended. Until is the word. Apparently, he was feeling dash about his bad luck. Apparently. Apparently means clearly. Apparently means clearly. He was feeling dash about his bad luck. Are you going to use anger? He was feeling angrily. He was feeling angry. Apparently, he was feeling angry. Or what is your option? He was feeling angry. He was feeling angry about his bad luck. Not anybody else. Not with anybody else. He was feeling angry about his bad luck. This is common for everybody. Then she dash her father. She has blue eyes. Okay. She dash her grandfather. She has blue eyes. DNA factors. She has blue eyes. So there are four phrasal verbs used. Takes after, takes on, takes in, takes to. So she takes after means resembled. Resembled means look alike sometimes. She takes after her grandfather means she looks like her grandfather, because she has blue eyes which are inherited from her grandfather. I think takes after is the correct answer for that. Takes after means resemble, look like. Not takes on. Takes on means assumes responsibility. The inspector of excise, customs duty. Excise means customs duty. Customs officer. The inspector of excise has to conduct regular checks and dash to visit the unit at least once a day. The inspector of excise has to conduct regular checks and is required to visit the unit at least once a day. And required is wrong. Requires is also. Anyhow, what is your answer? Is required. The inspector of excise has to conduct regular checks and dash to visit the unit at least once a day. Is required is the answer. That is, inspector is required. The inspector is requiring incorrect. The inspector required incorrect because active structure. When you use is required, this is passive structure, reporting type. Requires is not possible, therefore the correct answer is required. He has been recently discharged. He has been recently discharged dash the army. Discharged to or from by, which is your option? From, nice. Discharged from the army, discharged from the hospital, discharged from any other place where that individual is admitted to, where the individual is working. Discharged from. I wish I dash taller. So please look at this sentence and think about the pattern. Think about the pattern of the sentence. So once you realize the pattern of the sentence, it is easy for you to find out the answer. Note down the subject. I, subject, then I and the subject. So in a small sentence where two subjects are printed,
So in this case, next verb should be past verb or past participle. Accordingly, you must search for the answer. Maybe in this structure, so the verb should be a be verb. The verb should be one of the be verbs. So that one of the be verbs should be in past structure. So therefore, according to the rules, B might be the correct option. Yes. I wish I were taller. So what did I tell you to find out the answer, correct answer? You must note down the structure. And then, so while finding out the structure, we realize that there are two subjects. After the second subject, we should use always past be verb. Therefore, once you understood the pattern of the structure, it could be easier for you to provide the right option. Where is the answer? Dash, you do not work, you cannot succeed. Dash, you do not work, you cannot succeed. You do not work, you cannot succeed. So, which one? Which one can you use? This is very simple. If you do not work, you cannot succeed. Till you do not work, you cannot serve, that is not suitable. Or unless you do not work. If you use unless you do not work, there are two negatives. Unless is negative, then not is also negative. Then two negatives, what happens? So think like that. If you do not work, or if you don't work, or if you do not work, you cannot succeed. You cannot succeed. Understand? Unless you do not work is not correct, because unless is already a negative word, then another negative word. How can you use two negatives in a sentence? So you can correct your answer by yourself. So the right option is if is the right option. And then the sun dash at 6 this morning. The sun dash at 6 this morning. Arose, aroused, raised. So what is the right option? ROAC. The sun rose at 6 this morning. Don't confuse the spelling. This raised is different from this. Rose, huh? You are coming to the movie. You are coming to the movie. So what type of sentence is this? This is a question tag. This is a question tag. So just you find it. You are coming to the party is a question tag. Then you have to select appropriate question tag. You are, we were, or. So this is written in a contracted form. Or, then not, then you. Where this? You are coming to the movie. You are coming to the movie, aren't you? So D is the correct option here. D is the correct option because R in the question tag is reflected here, and then U is also reflected here, and you have to add not. So you must make sure that you have correctly selected the appropriate question tag here. How can you test this? You can test the very reflection of the same auxiliary verb used here, and also the same subject, and adding not. Then you will have the product of question tag. So, my dear young learners, so far we have covered more than 33 or 34 slides. Please go through all the 33 slides and you recall the use of preposition with the correct statement. Correct prepositions, correct adverbs, correct phrases, etc., etc. These are the appropriate times to refresh yourselves on the right usage of preposition. So with this, I conclude this session. Have a nice day.